What is going on, guys? Wiser here, bringing you some of the recaps of the most recent wars for 2.0. We have a couple good ones in here. Well, one was against this level 10 Turkish clan. Nothing too crazy. They used like only about 40 of 60 attacks. Kind of gave up at the end, but had some really nice TH10 triples in there to show you. And then I got the War Whales arranged matchup. And for anyone who follows us knows that War Whales definitely dominated us up top and was a bit of a struggle for us. But you know, War Whales is probably the best, if not definitely one of the best top fair play clans. I think the only arranged war that War Whales has ever lost, I don't even know if it was an arranged war against the Golden Goblins, that was just recently, you know, since Golden Goblins went fair play. Obviously, Supercell handed out their first round of bans, so that is a glorious sight to see for the fair play community, because they're following through with what they're talking about. And I think a lot of modders specifically, and even fair play guys, were very skeptical after the announcement about really what is going to be done. Is this actually going to have some follow through? Is this going to have some weight? Are they going to detect these things and be able to ban these guys? So anyhow, is what it is. Clash of Clans is cleaning up, and we like it over here at OneHive for sure. So anyhow, let's hop on in. Check out this first war, 8153. Really kind of rolled over these Turkish gentlemen and ladies over there. I don't know. But you can see they struggled. Missed all of our 11s there. Did have 2s on all the 10s, but pretty much 2s on all of the 9s, except for our boy Days there, who happened to get 3-starred by a go wipe. Sorry, Days. Think he was the only 3-star of the war. Is that true? Oh, Days for Days. Sorry, buddy. Is what it is. They were bound to get one though. So we did miss a couple of their 11s up there, but we were going for a lot of TH10 triples in here, and I got quite a few to show you. Did have a bully in there, but all the rest are 10 versus 10, so that is fantastic to see with a clean board all the way down. Did I miss one there? Did we miss one? No, we didn't miss one. Awesome. So anyhow, I'm just going to jump right in because I got a lot of replays to show you. Start off number 13, Salty McBalls. So obviously with the new overpowered Valks, a lot of these, all 5 of these attacks, very predominant Valk attacks. But just going to talk about what the necessities are when doing this, right? There's a few things that really hurt Valks. One, namely the CC troops. Obviously, the multi-target infernos are going to do some damage to them. So you got to have plans for those things specifically. So generally, what the Queen Wonks are doing here are taking out a chunk of the base, yanking out the CC, maybe getting one of the defensive heroes in the process. And you're going to see this exactly what Salty does. Takes out this compartment, walks up into here, pulls the CC out, continues his way along, and ends up taking out the defensive queen as well. And then once all that happens, look at this. This is a huge funnel already created. So Queen's going to continue to move on here, finish off this side of the funnel. As soon as that happens, he's got a clear path into that core. And if you can get Valks into that core under a raid spell, and it doesn't even matter. They don't even need a raid spell necessarily. You just get 10, 15 Valks into that core. This core is going to melt just instantly. So those Inferno Towers are going to go down right away. So really, guys, you just got to come up with a plan for the CC troops, the defensive Queen, and how do you funnel your Valks to the core or to the Inferno Towers you're trying to get? And you're going to have a lot of success, right? Very interesting. So here comes that jump spell. Here comes the Giants. They're going to walk right into those Expos. King walking in with them, setting off those bombs. Here come the Valk Parade in behind. Queen's doing her job. Takes down a defensive Queen in the process. Boom, ba boom. See you later. So all these Valks, look at this core to shred. Drops a heal to help them out. Soon as the Inferno Towers go down, the heal spell is going to help take them right back up. They're going to chew through these walls just instantly. And it comes a little few back-end hogs, right? Very compact compartments. There is a bomb there that goes off just before the hogs get there. So that was perfect timing for the Valks there to get there. And one more heal spell goes down. There's only like a couple small compartments of defenses left. This base is done for. I don't think Salty has lost even a troop this whole raid, maybe a Valk or two, and that was it. Like, look at all these troops left over. Tree in the bag, my friend. Nice job. Number 12, the Iceman. Going on one of these fashionable ring bases. Problem with these ring bases is you're going to see here, Ice brings a little bit of a queen walk. He's going to walk down and actually ends up busting through the wall. I don't know entirely if he had planned for the wall to be busted down like that, because I would have thought the queen would have just kept walking down into the 3 o'clock section, but whatever. You're going to see how this plays out. So the idea here again, right? He's pulled out the CC, so he's gonna yank that on over to this, over to the queen, over to his queen. Soon as that happens, the defensive queen's gonna hop up and suck her in. Maybe that's no. See, she's already attacking the wall right here, which I thought was very strange because you look at these two buildings; they're both targetable from the outside of the wall. Sometimes, to me, the queen just does very, very strange things. But is what it is. Poison spell goes down, helping things out. Gonna take care of that balloon before it even gets to the queen. Down it goes. Clean up those pups. Finish off going through the wall. She's gonna step up, take out that defensive queen, and then just leave a clear-cut path to the, for the Valks to get in there. A few more shots on that wall. She's gonna step up. Da-da-da. I think he has to burn the ability here. Yeah, that queen locks on. So good choice to burn that ability because his queen would not have taken it down in time. She would have got taken down. So anyways, busts it up and continues her way along the path. She's going to go in. Believe, send in. Here comes the golem and the giant. Wall breakers in behind. Boom, opens up the wall. Has to do a little bit of funneling action with the wizards here on the outside. Doesn't want his Valks wandering. Now you see this little building here. The Valks, it doesn't take it down, but the Valks go to it and then just go right in because there's nowhere else for them to go, really. Just shows if you really exaggerate and take out that far building on your funnel, even if you miss some of the close buildings, there's nowhere for them to go but back into the base. Now, unfortunately, they do not take the jump. I believe that is exactly what his plan was there. But doesn't really matter because a few of them end up routing back up. A few of them bust through this wall right here, which is kind of funny because there's a jump spell right there as well. And they all just kind of hang out around the outside while the king gets in there with the golem. A few more of them kind of slowly start trickling in out of that rage. Just start busting up these defenses. Boom, boom, boom. Down goes both Inferno Towers. Now, guys, I've talked about this before. Those were both single target Infernos. That is a huge piece of why this raid was successful. Now, maybe you guys can tell me, but I have not found a use for single target Infernos to be used in war, especially with how predominant Valks are. Guys, you have to have them on multi. Please, please, please keep that in mind. I cannot think of a use for having one of your Inferno targets set to multi. Love the wall breakers here on the backside to kind of let the Valks in and out. But there's really not much of this base tree in the bag for the Iceman. Job, buddy. number 10, self fence. So I thought this was cool. Self brings four healers, but it's not for a walk. Just immediately drops all these Valks. Drops some healers on the Valks back here to help keep them going. Has a CC full of Valks. Brings no golems, no giants, nothing. Double jump goes down very quickly, letting everything in compartment number one. This base is so boxy, kind of symmetrical, that you know those jump spells are going to get everything up to this point. And with the Lego walls having that many Valkyries, that means bad news because they're just going to shred through those walls very quickly. Both Inferno Towers are down. Raid spell, freeze spells go down, really helping get everything through that core. Has a few hogs trickling in on either side, just kind of taking care of those defenses as the Valks and King and everything are in there doing tanking. Valks bust through the wall, gonna continue some cleanup. And hogs end up pittering out somewhere kind of in this section, but there's just too much left. I think they take down that the wizard towers on the outer edge, but other than that, really this comes down to the few Valkyries that are remaining and the heroes cleaning this up. Fortunately, the expo locks on the queen, but it doesn't really matter because she still has the ability as well. See, there's a few Valkyries on this side kind of finally busting back into this chamber. They do get in, start kind of meeting up, end up helping out all the way through to this expo, and then there's only like a couple low level, you know, Town Hall 9 Arch Tower, Town Hall 9 Cannon, and like a Town Hall 7 Arch Tower there. So obviously this queen's going to finish mopping things up, has a minion helping out too. It's a sexy tree in the bag for self-fence. Nice job, buddy. Right, and number 9, Endless. Endless has been very, very clutch for us recently. Definitely one of our top Town Hall 10s right now in 2.0. Just really rocking it with these max heroes. So this little bit of a queen charge is going to complete exactly what I was talking about earlier. We're going to pull a CC out to her. She's going to take out a big chunk of the base, create part of the funnel, and boom, send a bunch of Valks in. Now again, both Infernos are in the core. If you can get the Valkyries into that core, you're looking pretty good because they're just going to take down those infernos, take down that core so quickly. They might even have time to bust through the walls on the other side and finish the base off for a 3-star. Now, that's kind of where we're at with Town Hall 10 right now, right? It's figuring out, deal with the CC. You're using Valkyrie, so you don't even really need to deal with the Queen because you know the Valks are just going to shred the Queen as soon as they get close to her. So it's not like you have to have a super good plan to take out the Queen before you send the Valks in. Really, it just comes down to taking care of the CC troops because only thing that can really hurt them are the Inferno Towers and are the CC troops. There's not a heck of a lot, especially if you got a heal spell for them like Endless does here. So in comes the Golem, right? Going to continue to create that funnel. Believe he's gonna open this wall up. There it goes. Wall breakers are in and successful. Opens up the wall. Gonna drop the king, drop his Valkyrie in behind now. Everything has one jump spell, opening up that core. He's gonna drop a rage here in 1 second. So there's another single target inferno. At least he has a multi on the back end, this guy. But again, with that rage spell, watch, boom, Valks are in there now. Down goes the inferno, down goes the town hall. Down goes that back end inferno. Goodbye, core. Right? So has hogs trickling in now in these very, very compact compartments. Has one heal spell, is going to drop over the 12 o'clock section. There it is. Going to heal the hogs and the Valks at the same time. Really nice job. Gets the king in there. Gets the king's barbs in there. Really just perfect heal placement. This base does not stand a chance. Sexy tree in the bag. Job, Endless. So it was a TH11 bully, and then one more, our war general, Dirty Italian, doing a cleanup attack here. I believe self-defense had a 99% on this base. So DI just copied it, made a couple small adjustments. Really, I probably should have shown this base for a cleanup episode, but oh well, too late. So DI brings 8 healers here. Now 4 for the Queen. He's gonna pull the CC over to her. Take care of that. Wizard jumps in there, kind of giving an assist on that Lava Hound. Fortunately, does have to hit the ability. One balloon drop would have finished off his Queen, so had to hit the ability before the balloon was there. No big deal. Just mopping up those pups now. Kind of a scary moment for the Queen. She gets pretty low on health, but no big deal, right? Things are good. Earthquake goes down, opens up the core, has a jump spell with the earthquake. So that is a big piece of this raid as well. I believe the jump just goes flat out right over top. He uses these two buildings side by side as the breadcrumb. Now the Valks are going to, you drop Valks in front of it, they're obviously instantly going to go in between. If there's a jump spell here, he does not even need to funnel off that army camp because they're just going to jump right into this core and get all that great, great juicy value in there. So there goes the jump spell. In comes the Valks. Does not bring a Golem, does not bring Giants, brings a CC full of Valks and about 14 more. King goes in behind everything. 4 healers in, helping things out. These healers on the Valks are really, really getting good value. Unfortunately, obviously, they don't do anything for the Infernos, but look at that free spell, too. Gets the Expo, the Tesla, and the Inferno Tower. Valks are now in, right in that core. Take down the heroes, take down the town hall. Got to get on over to those Inferno Towers. Down goes one, down goes two. Raid spell just lighting things up. Queen's continuing to just walk around the base, do cleanup, drops an archer to archer and a wizard, I believe, on the 9 o'clock to quickly start some cleanup action over on this side. Because that's really what South's attack came down to, was just one cleanup troop. That's all it would have taken. Bam, bam, bam. See you later. And there's really one compartment of stuff to go. Still has 3, 4 Valkyries in there. Nice job, DI. Tree in the bag for my dirty friend. Beautiful. So nice war 2.0. Really good bounce back war after the War Whales defeat, because obviously that was a tough one for us. And let's just jump right over and check it out. War Whales. 84 to 78 was the final. Obviously, these guys are very, very good. Like I had mentioned before, in my opinion, the number one fair play clan. But we'll see what happens now that modders are getting banned, and really, there's a lot of modding, ex-modding clans putting together some quote-unquote fair play clans. The problem, and let me talk about the problem so far. We were talking about this in fair play chat, or Hody was, I should say. about what do we do, right? We can't just let ex-modders into the clan. Now, here's why. Not saying that they're not fair play now, but what happens if modding cracks what Supercell's been doing next week? As a first example. Well, how do you know that these guys aren't just going to go right back to modding? In fact, they probably would, especially if it was that soon. Most of them, I guarantee, would start modding again. And we just can't be in that position as a clan. If that happens, we need to explore the longevity of what Supercell is doing here and make sure it sticks and make sure that the game really is cleaned up before we even consider that. Now, here's another thought. You can still mod. I can still go in and I can say, okay, if I'm the enemy, I can go and scout this guy's base. And I could just look at the base just like this and copy this into my modding program. You wouldn't know where the traps were, okay? But you could make some good educated guesses, right? You could throw some Teslas probably in this compartment. Like, there's obviously these open spaces there for a reason. Probably, I'd imagine at least two or three there. I didn't actually watch this replay, so I have no idea. However, my point is, you can still mod. I can still copy this base manually into the modding program. I can guess where the traps are, and I can practice against it, right? I can't save the 3-star hit once I get it and one touch it in war. That can't happen anymore. However, you can still mod in a way. You can still take this base, plug it into your program, guess where the traps are, and practice it all day long until you get it. You still have to manually execute it in war. However, why do we want to have that headache? Why do we want to worry about who's doing that? Oh, hello, honey. And my biggest fan has now joined me. Hope she didn't spend any of my gems because my Clash of Clans is open on my phone. Yes, my daughter has spent my gems before. One time she upgraded, when I was town online, she upgraded my Tesla. Upgrade, she freed up a builder, upgraded the Tesla, and completed the upgrade for a whopping amount of like 1600 gems or something like that. Anyhow, is what it is. I guess I need to put a password on my phone. There you go, sweetheart. Why is it not playing? Sorry about this, guys. You're welcome. All right. So, anyhow, guys, that's kind of where we're at. A lot of the Fair Play community feels the same about us. Some people do not, though. Oh, bless you. I know there's some other Fair Play clans that are okay with having ex-modders in their clan. I don't understand how that's even possible. That doesn't seem very Fair Play to me. Especially because you know you can still mod. It just you can't. You can't send any data or receive any data from the Supercell servers, so you got to guess the base, but that still gives you a leg up. And if guys are still doing that, I still don't like. You don't like it. You can't control that, obviously. But why would you ever want, as a Fair Play clan, committing to the Fair Play community? Why would you ever want that? So any clans out there that are Fair Play that are accepting ex-modders, I strongly, strongly encourage you to. Sorry, I just got to turn this down. But I strongly encourage you guys to reconsider having ex-modders in your clan because to me, it's just going to cause you a whole lot of headache down the road. And especially because this is so new and so fresh. We have no idea how long it's going to last, guys. So just something to keep in mind. Anyhow, got a few town online attacks here. Like I had mentioned real quick, let's just check out War Whales. Did their diligence, right? Twos on everything, right? One, two, three, and four Town Hall 10 triples for them. Clean up the nines like champs. Nice job, War Whales. Had to use three bullies. Now, one of our, I had a horrible war. My only saving grace this war was, let's take a look at this. We had, boom, Wiser Man had five defends. Finally, got cleaned up by a bully. Me and Kadok both, Kadok had three defends and then got cleaned up by a bully. Homestar had four defends before Town Hall 9 finally got him. Rob had a pretty good couple defends there, right? So, our base building was pretty good, I would say, on the Town Hall 9s, right? You see a lot of, I mean, let's go Town Hall 9 and down. I mean, yeah, 2-2, 1-1-1, but you get 5-4, 5-3. So there were some successes within our base building there, so we're really happy. War Whales did have to use three bullies to finish off the nines. We also had to use three bullies to finish off the nines. So our nines versus nines were pretty much right on par with each other. And it came down to the top. As you can see, we missed one of the Town Hall 11s, we missed one of the Town Hall 10s, just the 2 stars, and then got no 3 stars on the Town Hall 10s. So you look at the difference in score, 84 to 78, well, those 2 2-stars is 84 to 80, and then the 4 TH10 triples that War Whales had and the 0 that we had, that's the 4-star 4-star difference. So nice job, War Whales. Great war. Always fun matching you guys. You guys are just beasts over there. Let's just jump right in. Check Nightmare here. Hitting one hive. Sam's first arranged war with War Whales. Sam, you know, I got you on Twitter. I was watching you through your tryouts for War Whales. Just a fantastic job, buddy. Great first war for you to have, and great victory for you guys to get. So congrats, I will say. We recognize a lot as 2.0 of where our struggles are and what we need to do to be competing within these top fair play clans. And we got a ways to go. Definitely recognize that. No one's fault. We're just still in that growing phase. Still have a lot of 9.5s that are training up. A lot of brand new 10s that are still working up. So a little bit more time, and we should be right in the mix of everything, hopefully. And, you know, we're recognizing things and progressing day to day here. So that is fantastic to see. All these Valks are now in on the Queen Chamber. Look how fast she goes down. Queen's in there, right? Good old double jump. Now, what I liked here was this jump, the very first jump. No wall breakers. Says, you know what? All right. Says, I don't need wall breakers. Hogs in, kind of sprinkled in on both sides here. Has a few down here, a few over here, and the rest of them in from 11 to 12 o'clock. One heal spell goes down, taking care of everything. All the defense is going down at the same time. Has a few Golemites even in there, tanking for the Queen. Queen's already hit the ability, though, so his archers are right up in front. He's got to work through that high hit point stuff. The Valkyries and King are bust out of the wall down here, out of the Queen Chamber. Do a little bit of cleanup. Hogs end up hitting a DGB. How perfect would that have been if he did not hit that DGB? Really good hidden DGB there, though, I will say, right? One on either side of the wall with the little... That's a nice, tricky DGB front of that Tesla. Really like that one. There's Sammy Boy. But was not enough to hold off Nightmare. Works through that Tesla. Queen has a sliver of health. Just has to take down that last Rax. And it's tree in the bag. Mm-hmm. All right. Go down here. Number 14 things. Nightmare had a six-pack. Had a lot of Town Hall 9 six-pack heroes. So I like this one because Zero only brings 3 healers. Now, this is a max Town Hall 9. For me to bring 3 healers, that would be a scary, scary thought for myself. But what he recognizes is, look, point defense, splash, splash, point defense. Way down here, point defense. So those 3 point defense are the only things that are going to be hitting her on this whole side. So she doesn't have a lot to worry about. So 3 healers, right? That saves you 14 troop space. That's a couple more hogs. That is another Valk and another wizard and minion, right? You got a lot of options saving that healer. 14 troop space is a big investment, especially if you don't need it, which Zero clearly does not here. So going to continue to just walk down here, takes that out. I believe he sends in a hog here in one moment to get the CC pulled out. Yep, there it goes. Going to run that thing in, pull the CC on over to the Queen. Sends the second hog, but actually did not need to, but very wisely was ready to send that second hog. That Tesla popped and didn't think he was going to quite get the drag out, but ends up getting it anyways. Just finishes off that dragon. Drops the wizard to help out. Drag locked onto the healer, so that was a scary moment for a second. But ends up finishing it off. Wizard's up there kind of just hanging out now. I love that. Does not follow the Queen, which is absolutely stupid, but whatever. So in comes this cold-blooded golem, creating his funnel. Going to open up this wall. Successfully does so. And has 8 Valkyries he is about to send in with this golem and his king. Get a jump spell number 1 down, jump spell number 2 down. Essentially unlocking this whole top of the base. Bye, sweetheart. Thanks for visiting. So, jump spell number 1. Look at these Valks just do work. Bam, just a couple shots, takes down that DE storage. Now, only has 12 hogs here, so does need to get pretty good value out of these Valkyries, and is doing pretty good so far, right? Gets both those Teslas, has to get in on top. Heal spell goes down to help things out. Poison spell goes down to slow down that Queen. Absolutely perfect timing on that. She didn't even take one shot before she was under poison. Bam, down she goes. Valks just shred heroes like crazy now. So a few hogs now on the Queen Chamber to help the Valkyries out. Has a couple that he probably... didn't need to send up here. Oh, I guess he gets that bomb out of the deal. So gets the Tesla and the sweeper, but has sliver of health on those hogs, actually. So really good job triggering that DGB with two hogs. Just absolutely perfection on this raid zero. Very nice. Tree in the bag. All right. Keep moving on here. My man Jacob officially moved up to 2.0 recently, probably long overdue because this man does serious work for our clan. Just love you, Jacob. Love seeing your activity. Love seeing you help pretty much every single person in Invicta and 2.0. Help plan attacks. Help everything, right? Like you do so much for this clan. I can't express my gratitude enough. But this little attack, of course, I had to show one Lalo in this whole recap. Opens up the base. Queen's going to move in here, start taking all this stuff out. Golems are moving in. Defensive Queen is now down. King's going to walk right in. Has to get a poison down for those CC troops. Down it goes. It's all very, very light troops. Has a witch kind of on the back end there, but she's going to jump right into that poison. No big deal. Skellies get taken down. Everything just getting worked on here. Jump spell number one goes down. Going to force everything into this box compartment over here. Did not want to connect the CC compartment here, I believe. Just want to continue everything down. So make sure that the king gets into this air defense. Now watch what happens. Does not quite get the air defense. Oh, not quite. So the air defense stays up. But literally a balloon or a pup spits on that air defense and it's going to go down. So no big deal. Has a haste spell and a raid spell going down. Just kind of almost surgically picking apart all of these, the 3 o'clock and the 6 o'clock sections, right? Hounds in, and then a few balloons. Hounds in, few balloons, right? Raid spells go down. Has this huge whack of balloons moving on over to this expo now. Has this lava hound. Just perfect timing, gets it to burst right as it gets over there. One touch from a pup and the air defense goes down. Haste spell goes down, has a couple loons distracting that wizard tower. Just beautiful, Jacob. Perfect execution here, buddy. Tree in the bag. All right. Oh, I did have one more here I want to show you. Good old Robbie. Robbie had a six pack too, actually. Our bottom beast, keeping true. Love this guy. Although for bottom beast, he's getting pretty high heroes now. 28-25. Nice job there, Robbie. So you can see the cold blooded golems in there. If you can manage to get it to tank everything you need it to tank, so you can create that funnel, you may as well only bring one just because of how powerful Valks are right now. So in comes the queen, in comes the king, in come all the Valks. CC is also full of Valks, I believe. Maybe I'm wrong. Oh, I'm wrong. CC must have hogs in it. He has 20 hogs still in the bag, though. So one jump goes down. Going to heal up the Valks, get them on over to that queen. Down goes that defensive queen. A couple shots. Drops cleanup wizard on the outside. Take care of that mortar. Just perfect. Look at all those wizards. That's a very scary moment. If you don't get a poison, look at this is why I want to show this raid. Okay, watch these wizards. I know they're supposed to move out of the poison when there's no offensive troops on the board. But look at the move here. Watch these wizards. Let's watch the look at this one wizard. He moves back. It's like he takes a step back. It's like he's running away. Crazy. I don't know. I never noticed that about the AI. I don't know if it's just because the poison was there. I don't know. I can't explain that. But I was watching when all the wizards came out, the poison went down, they all kind of took a step back. And then another poison down, and they kind of started to take a step back again. I just thought that was really strange AI. But whatever, poisons take care of wizards, no problem, especially when you got a bunch of Valks and a king in there doing work. So in comes the hogs, sends in a ton of them under the heel here. Now, does not quite have enough down here, I believe, to get through all of this stuff. Has a few of them split off to that sweeper, which I think is perfect because he sets off that bomb and the heal wears off. So he doesn't even get through that first Tesla. Never mind the second Tesla. But he's got about 8 or 10 maybe even hogs under that heal there. Full health coming in. The Teslas and the mortar are literally the only things to go. Kablam, kablam. Down goes that defensive king. And it's cleanup. Nice job, Robbie. Tree in the bag. All right. So, you know, tough war. Again, learned a lot though. Not only about our attacks and how we need to adjust up top with our attacking and to come away with a better result. On top of it, just our base building a little bit too. We're really working on some stuff. Mechanic, DI, and actually Endless as well. Trying to put our heads together here and start creating a Town Hall 10 base building guide from some things we are learning from matching up against great clans like War Whales. Seeing where our shortcomings are, obviously things like that. I mean, South Fence with a 60% one star, that's a tough one, right? That's a star we should have had. Iceman, 72% on number four. That is a star we should have had. So some struggles here, guys. No one's fault. We're working hard. We're getting better each day, and I love seeing it. We're rocking these forum bases, so it's just a matter of getting a little more practice on fair play, top tier war bases, and just getting it down. And we're working on it every day. And I love seeing it. Love seeing the positivity from the clan in our chats all around. So 2.0, love you guys. Hopefully, we have a little bit better result next time. I think we're taking next weekend off, just kind of regroup a little bit and discuss some stuff and get a little bit more time in our hands to work on some things that we need to work on. And we'll be back in a couple weeks with another arranged war. Pretty sure I know which one's coming in 2 weeks, but I do not want to announce it yet. But it should be a doozy. Anyhow, guys, I think that'll do it here for your wisdom from Wiser. Just trying to help me bag that next tree star. Till then, I'm out.